Hey everybody, this is Alex King with A King TV, and we are back with another reaction. It looks like Eminem has returned and has dropped, I believe, a 4-pack on us. So I'm super happy about that, super excited because, of course, it's Eminem. Like, who wouldn't be happy, right? So hopefully you get to share with me in this treat of listening to Eminem doing this reaction. Hopefully your days are going well, by the way. That's number one, right? Hopefully everything's going on well with you all. I truly hope it is. With no further delay, let's go ahead and get into this. It's Eminem featuring 2 Chainz. The song is called Kyrie and Luka. Actually, really quick, I think I actually heard about this beforehand, like when the album first dropped, if I'm not mistaken. I think I heard about this during that time period. I thought maybe it got scrapped or something like that. I also wonder if the J. Cole feature is actually going to be in this 4-pack too, but that's besides the point. Let's go ahead and check into it now. Kyrie and Luka. Okay. Old school New York boom bap type beat. Hey. Makes me want to rap right now. Like, check it, check it, check it, check it, check it, check it. Oh, if I don't see it, then I don't believe it. I done done some pretty dumb things on the tequila. First off, I think he said powder on the plate, turn your girl to Eureka. Cause she about to, her mind about to go, woo. Especially if it's depending on how much powder is on that plate too. I mean, I would imagine even a small amount might make her mind go, woo. Right? Goodness. 2 Chainz has an interesting style of rap. I really enjoyed his run back in the day when he was doing like what song, Mercy, with Kanye and Big Sean. Lamborghini Mercy, your girl she's so thirsty. Yeah, that he had a great run. He was on Effing Problems back in the day with Kendrick and Sean, right? No, Kendrick, ASAP, and Drake. So he's had a good run. So I'm actually just excited to see him and the Eminem's actually, you know, doing a song with him, because Eminem doesn't do features with everybody. So this is dope. On the tequila, birthday in Vegas, laying with my reason. Ask the bottle friend, she like, boy, I don't believe you. I'm just trying to live, and they turned into evil. There's a grip, the only thing you need is seafood. Tough. Really quick. So there's going to be stopping, especially more likely due to the Eminem anyway. So if y'all don't like stopping and things like that, then I apologize. But there's nothing I can do about it. It's going to be some bars that need to be touched on. First off, his partner's a crip. All he eats is seafood is crazy. Like, the fact that no other rapper, I don't think, has ever said anything like that before, at least not to my recollection, is interesting. Because crips always use C words. They don't use any words to have the letter B in it and things like that. It's a great play off the fact that it's seafood and seafood, which is crazy. Love it. You know my set, I'm throwing dollar signs. I lick the neck and turn a body to a water slide. I'm in the bottom of my bag like some high fry. Tony, that my top eye. Shit, and why me swag on this beat? You know, I'm in the bottom of my bag like some hot fries. I thought he was thinking about like hot fries to chips, but he might just be talking about like French fries, like when your French fries spill out your bag, out your cup that it comes in, and then you find extra fries in the bottom of your bag, right? That's what I would assume he's talking about. Enough to make Rakim proud of me. Yep. You got my map and your bitch ass post something negative. You could have called me. That's a fact. I'm from the dark side, but the whip light skin. Woo. I do what I wanna do like white men. Ha. I hit you in the fucking head with the mic stand. I fuck my girl in the daytime on a nightstand. You know that, did you? Real recognize, real. That's what I was saying. He has his own unique style of doing things, because saying he has sex with his girl in the daytime on a nightstand is such like a 2 Chainz line. Like, it's nothing super profound, but it's, he's still saying something, right? It's interesting. Like, he has his own style, is what I can say. Like, you either like it or you don't. But you also have to understand of what you're going to get when you have him on your song, right? For when you listen to him.
feeling, you don't look familiar. I'm from Riverdale Road, we ain't got no river. Got the pole concealed behind the partition. Listen,
Riverdale Road with no river is crazy.
A trap nigga, I perform in the crystals. I ain't gonna fight, but I still told pistol.
Oh,
all I got to do is whistle.
Facts. The yo, I'm not gonna fight you, but I still carry that pistol. All I gotta do is whistle. Yeah, cause there's people, around him that'll handle the business for him. I feel like once you get to a certain position, when you have a certain amount of money, if you don't have security and people around you to protect you, then it's just silly. We've seen too many rapper deaths where people got touched because they didn't have enough security, or at least adequate security. Like, man, I'd be rolling with security in general. Like, I'm going, like, even, like they gotta live in my house. Like, because it's gonna be crazy. Like, I always go back and think about Nipsey and Pop Smoke and stuff like that, too. And, of course, Tupac and Biggie and everybody else. But it's crazy to me. It really is. So he's right.
They've been plagiarizing, they've been stealing songs. As soon as I see them, I'm gonna pick them off.
Pick them off, 2 Chainz.
Mustache, Ricky Ross. Huh. God took his time with me. Kingpins wanna sign with me.
Woo.
Gunshots is truly Atlanta. Well, things that go left like Julius Randle.
Okay.
I got the shit lit, no need for a counter. Shit like Kyrie, I got the shit handled.
Yes. Handle King Kyrie. Handle King Kyrie. So, 2 Chainz seems like he just finished his verse, so I don't really have much to say. I'm just excited to get into this Eminem verse. I think Chainz came through and did what Chainz does, and now I'm here for the greatness that Eminem is about to do.
Walking around your party like where the party at.
Woo!
Bacardi and yak could lead to a cardiac.
Facts.
And I give a fuck like how cardiac. I'm
on there.
I just had to run to my cardiac. Headache and the leave.
The cardiac bars is crazy. Throwing in the fact about Cardi in it. The rapper Cardi B, cardiac, Cardi. Like, I would imagine there's probably some Bacardi stuff in there too. It's coming on the song already saying, in the party, asking where the party at. Yeah, because y'all not partying the way I need y'all to party. In the party, asking where the party at. Nah, because there's also sections inside of parties where the party is more lit inside of a party. Like, oh, I'm in the party, but over there in that back area, that's where the party is and that's where I need to be. Let me go back there. People getting girls.
Let me put it more delicately. Fuck your feelings, I'm a felon pussy. You're jealous of me. Probably cause my cerebellum's a parabellum pussy. Even if I swear to sell a pussy, I'd still be like a female that's hooking. Ain't shit you can do to stop me from selling pussy. Yeah.
Ooh, that boy nasty, man. That boy nasty. I know kind of what he said, but I definitely want to run it back because how he put it all together to talk about him and his record sales, about prostitution and selling cat, like how he did that. That's one of my favorite things about Eminem is how he's able to formulate his bar setups to be able to go from here just to get to these points over here. And you'd be like, that was like flawless. Like that nasty. And that definitely came from the fact that he used to do battle rap and stuff like that, because that's what a lot of battle rappers do. And not too many people in rap do that today, unfortunately, which I definitely feel like it's missing. That gives Eminem like extra sauce on his bars and his lyrics. Hold on. Yep. Yep. Fire. Washed up shorelines.
I'm a search till I find the most awful this line as possible. Mind is off. All I need is a small little pint of vodka to be talked into trying to walk up inside of a Shriners hospital. And they're trying to make Marshall the guy responsible for little Joshua's giant arsenal. Like I'm also the reason it's nine.
Yeah, when people be like, oh, these school shootings and things happen because of like rap music and movies and things like that. Well, they usually say rap music or the music that they were listening to. They rarely ever talk about the video games. They rarely ever talk about the movies. It's always about music. Which is so crazy to me because there's way more gun stuff in movies and TV shows than there are in regards to music. If hearing somebody say gun in a rap song makes someone go commit crimes and murders more than actually seeing violence in a movie, then there's something wrong. Something's truly wrong. Like, I don't believe it in the slightest. I grew up listening to hip-hop and rap, too. I listen to some rock music. I listen to a few different things. And there's never been a case where I've been like, let me go and do this. No, there's not. There's not. It's ridiculous. We'd actually have way more gun violence and more violence in general if that was the case. Ridiculous. And he brought his tool and decides to hide inside of his locker till the next time he's picked on at school. But you're out of your gourd if you're thinking that I ain't killing this beat. I'm not even forcing myself to vomit. But if I had a fucking eating disorder or anorexia, believe me, I couldn't body this more for you. Yeah. That was crazy! Crazy. That was insane. I couldn't body dysmorphia. Body dysmorphia? Even if I had an eating disorder, anorexia, bulimia, I couldn't body dysmorphia. Oh, that is. Yeah. Yeah. Whew. So, J. Cole being my favorite rapper before the apology. Hearing him say stuff like this always reminds me of how much better I feel like the old school rappers were, and Eminem's now an older school rapper, right? Because I look at it and I'm like, hearing Jay say certain things on verses when Jay comes into those features, and I'm blown away, or hearing, let's say, Wayne say certain things when he hops on features, I find it to be ridiculously incredible. And I feel like we're missing a certain point of rap. Because even Kendrick has great, he raps at a high level, but he's still not saying things like this and like and how he puts it together. He may say things similar, but he's not putting it together the same way. J. Cole may say great things, but he's not putting it together the same way that these older people are doing it, like the older tops. And it makes sense because they've had more experience rapping and doing things and thinking of more things to try to change up how they're doing it. So it is amazing. Like, which also makes me always say, man, I wish King Los was out here actually, you know, popular, because the bar for rapping would be superbly elevated too. But man, that was crazy. Go Eminem. That I ain't killing this beat, I'm not even forcing myself to vomit. But if I had a fucking eating disorder or anorexia, believe me, I couldn't body dysmorphia. Yeah. Man, I'm beyond childish. When I'm on Valiums, just like mom downs them, they call it Munchausen. Cause she hands me some, says, come on, Chausen. These are non-drowsing. I mean non-drowsing. What the hell? Munchausen disease? Mom says, come on, try some. It's crazy because you're munching on them. That. Yo, this man. Just like mom downs them, they call it Munchausen. Cause she hands me some, says, come on, Chausen. These are non-drowsing. I mean non-drowsy. What the hell, you calm down some. So before I song out him, trying to make Rob proud him, hoping this song rouse him. I pop like 9,000. I'm out of 5,000. Hold up. Spit syllables on a mic in a booth like I'm a Drew's. Even if I wanna lose, I'm in the news. Even my interviews get like 5 million views. I get accused of misogyny because I will misogyny. If it's just like a masseuse fixing knife on the moon, signing a bruise, hiding the side of my shoes. That's like, I'm just playing fucking mumble rap. Yo, I don't even care. I don't even care, bro. I don't even care. Eminem's a goat. Eminem's a goat. Man, that was fire. Fire. And if y'all disagree, we got problems. And you need to explain it to me in the comments, since nobody believe in comments. People be watching, and I'll be getting some likes. Not many likes. But we're growing as a channel. I need some comments, guys. Let me know what you thought in regards to the song. Was it fire? Was it trash? I think it was fire. You should also think it's fire. Eminem fans, let me know your thoughts. Not Eminem fans, let me know your thoughts. And if you like specific bars, let me know what specific bars you liked that I missed, or specific bars that you just liked in general. And also, let me know some Eminem songs also to check out in regards to it, because I'm going to do the rest of the songs he dropped. But let me know some other Eminem songs to check out, because I definitely haven't listened to all Eminem's music. But the ones I have heard, fire. But anyway, it's been great doing this reaction with you all. Feel free to like, comment, share, subscribe. And until next time, I'm out.